The Drude theory is basically a kinetic theory for electrons. It is very crude in the sense that it assumes electrons to move freely in metals. But despite its crudeness, it works remarkably well. Even to this day, for many discussions, it is often the first model we look at when we want to get an intuition. So let us get an idea what the Drude model is about. In 1900, German physicist Paul Drude developed this theory for electrons in metals. He realized that he could apply Boltzmann's kinetic theory for gases to understand the electron's motion. There are three assumptions to consider. First, we introduce a scattering time tau. It says that the probability of scattering within a time interval dt is dt over tau. Tau should be understood as a phenomenological parameter. For the kinetic theory of molecules, we could estimate the scattering time tau based on the velocity, density, and scattering cross-section. But it is hard to estimate the scattering time for electrons, as they can scatter with many things besides other electrons in a solid. Also, electrons mainly interact via long-range Coulomb interaction. So it is hard to define a cross-section. Therefore, our first assumption is just that this scattering time tau exists. Secondly, once the electron scatters, it returns to zero momentum. That is, as soon as an electron bumps into anything else, it fully stops moving. In reality, it would go off in some direction with a final momentum depending on its scattering partner due to momentum conservation. But on average, when we take the mean over a period of time, it will be zero, because clearly it would be averaged over all kinds of directions. And lastly, the third assumption is that the electrons respond to external forces in between scattering events. The force can be due to applied electric and magnetic fields that couple to the electron's charge, like in the Lorentz force. Now, let's use these three assumptions. There is an electron at time t with momentum p. A bit later in time, it has the momentum p of t plus dt. When the electron did not scatter, the momentum can be expanded. We discover Newton's definition of the force and get a simple expression. That expression has to be multiplied with the probability that the electron did not scatter. When the probability of scattering is dt over tau, then the probability of not scattering is 1 minus dt over tau. Now, in the event of scattering, the momentum becomes zero. Then we multiply everything out and keep only terms of linear order in dt. Rearranging a bit yields the equation of motion for the Drude model. When the force is zero, the solution becomes obvious. An exponential ansatz results in a momentum p of t that starts out at p0 and rapidly decays. It is as if the scattering is dragging the electron down, simply bringing them to a halt within some phenomenological timescale tau. That's pretty much it.